Hi, my name is John. I'm a librarian at ZSR. Today we're going to be talking about how you can use Zbib, aka Zotero Bib, to generate really fast citations and bibliographies for your papers. Zbib is a fully online alternative to Zotero. If you feel comfortable installing and learning new software on your computer, I recommend that you check out the full Zotero to get the most out of your citation manager. If you're looking for something more lightweight and easier to learn, Zbib will be perfect for you. Zbib is also a great option if you're using a device like a Chromebook or an iPad that can't install the full Zotero, or if you're looking for a more powerful alternative to EasyBib. Alright, let's get started. You can get to Zbib from any online device by going to zbib.org. That's zbib.org. The first thing you'll see here is a search bar. This is where you'll either look up the sources you want to cite, or enter URLs from sources you've already found. Once you add your sources there, they'll show up here in your bibliography. You can see that it's empty right now. After you fill up your bibliography, you can use the export button to get your sources out of here and into your paper. Let me show you what the research process looks like when you're using Zbib. I've already got some resources pulled up here in my other tabs. First, I've got a scholarly article from a medical journal. All I need to do is copy the URL of the resource and paste it into my search bar. There you go. It finds the information and creates a citation for me automatically. Second, I've got a print book from our ZSR catalog. I can do the same thing here. I'll just copy the URL that points to this book and paste it into my search bar. As you do your research and you find sources that you like, just copy those URLs into Zbib to keep track of them. Third, I've got an ebook on ProQuest eBook Central. I'll just copy the URL into the search bar and... It looks like Zbib got this one wrong because our proxy server is in the way. That's fine because I've got some other options here. The search bar doesn't just accept URLs. I can go back to my ebook here and find the ISBN instead. The ISBN, by the way, is just an identifying number that belongs only to this title. I'll just paste that here instead, and there it is. Everything we need. You can also use the search bar to try to find anything you can't otherwise identify. I'll just do a search here for the book Shock Doctrine by Naomi Klein. It takes a second to look around, and then I just pick it out from this list of results. Now I've got a real bibliography here. You can see that the default citation is set to Modern Languages Association 8th Edition, or MLA 8, but I can change that whenever I want. I'll just change it to Chicago style so you can see it update my bibliography. Let's go back to MLA 8 for now, though. Like it says, there are more than 9,500 citation styles available through Zbib, and yes, they are all completely free. Just search for the one you need if it's not in the original list. With your bibliography all set, let me show you how to get stuff out of Zbib and into your paper. Here's a blank Word document. I'll just start typing like I'm writing something very profound here. When I get to the point where I need to create an in-text citation, I just hop back over to Zbib, click my Copy Note button, select a page number if I need to, let's just say 40, and paste it in my document over here. I'll just do this a few more times until I've cited everything once. Once I reach the end of my paper, I am ready to insert my full bibliography or works cited list. I'll just head down to the Export button and copy the whole thing to my clipboard. Now I'll just paste it into my document. You can see that it might paste it in a different font, but you can change that as needed inside your document. You can also use that export button to download your bibliography if you want to have a saved version of it on your computer. If you want to save your bibliography for later without downloading anything, you can also use the Link to this version feature to create an online version of your bibliography that you can access from anywhere with this URL. Warning: Zbib doesn't know when it makes a mistake. It's just a bunch of lines of code that do what they're told. Make sure that you know enough about your citation style that you can correct any mistakes that Zbib makes. And always compare your Zbib citations to the properly formatted examples we have online at zsr.wfu.edu/citations. That's the basics of Zbib. I hope this video has been helpful. If you have any questions about Zbib, Zotero, or citations in general, just ask ZSR at our email, askzsr@wfu.edu. That's askzsr@wfu.edu. See you next time.